This episode of D News is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way. Spring has sprung. Twitter painted animals are getting all cuddly and then it's over. It was so fast. What happened? Hey everybody, thank you for watching D News today. I'm Trace. We are living in uncertain times. Our lives are short and the universe is constantly changing. Not always for the better or for the worse, it just is changing. So let's lay it all out there so we can build a bridge and get over it. What do you say? Spring gets 30 seconds to a minute shorter every year. According to the director of the Goddard Institute for Space Studies, in the year 8680, Northern Hemisphere spring is going to be 4 days shorter, guys. Spring is caused by the Earth beginning to tilt toward the sun. It starts on the vernal equinox, which is when the axis is exactly vertical. Over the next 92.76 days, we're all going to get closer to the sun as the wobble gets more pronounced. And then summer's going to start. The wobble isn't constant, though. Over time, precession happens. Basically, the wobble shifts about 1 degree every 72 years. This changes a lot of things. Summer lengthens, and so does autumn. Spring and winter get a little shorter. Then it's going to come back around. The North Star, Polaris, is at the north now, but thanks to that axis wobble and precession, it's actually changing ever so slowly. In 12,000 years, Vega, not Polaris, is going to be the North Star. Vega is way brighter than Polaris, so that's kind of nice, but every 26,000 years, the two kind of trade back and forth. And speaking of north, the magnetic North Pole isn't constant either. Everything you know is a lie. That's right, when your compass points north, it's not actually pointing at the top of the planet, it's just close. Earth's magnetic field determines where magnetic north falls. It can move as much as 50 miles in a single day. Back in 1831, magnetic north was closer to the top of Canada's Hudson Bay, while today it's 685 miles closer to true north, but it is still moving. The South Pole moves too, guys, so don't think you're left out. Scientists believe that as the speed of Earth's iron core shifts, the magnetic field also shifts, but they're not entirely sure why. Scientists can actually watch the poles moving around thanks to the ESA's swarm satellites, which is actually kind of freaky. And if the north thing isn't freaking you out yet, how about something a little close to home? If you wanted more hours in the day, just wait. The days are getting longer. The Earth and Moon are constantly interacting with each other gravitationally. Every year, the Moon takes a few centimeter baby step away from us, and every time it wants to get out, we pull it back in. Over millions of years, Earth's rotation slows because of this pulling, and our day actually gets longer. 620 million years ago, the day was only 21 hours long. Every century, the day gets 1/500th of a second longer. In fact, the International Earth Rotation and Reference System Service, obviously my dream job, announced that in June, we're going to have a leap second added to the calendar. There is a hypothesis, though, that a leap second could break the internet, literally. Computers do not handle change well, even worse than humans do. New set, remember? If some computers thought that it was midnight and others thought it was midnight in 1 second, havoc would ensue. In June of 2012, Reddit, Gawker, and Yelp were all taken down because of a leap second bug. Qantas Airlines had to delay their flights because of their leap second bug. We've had 25 leap seconds since 1972 when the idea was created, but there are more and more computers around now. So we're just gonna have to trust the engineers, I guess. That's pretty freaky on its own way. In the grand scheme of things, humans don't live very long. Even the oldest person ever, she was 122, in comparison to Earth time, that's just a blink. Because of our limited viewpoint, we think things are stable, but the North Pole, the North Star, how long the seasons of the year, the day, they're all constantly adjusting and changing. Nature is amazing and kind of scary. But what do you guys think about all this? Why don't you tell me down in the comments, make sure you subscribe for more D News, and keep being freaked out by the world around you. Thanks for watching. This episode of D News is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.